How do you get your kids to t-ball and get to the gym? You know, how do you do all this? So they came and took pictures, and they did a 5-page story in People Magazine about my family. And I was in the cover, and then as I wrote books, they put me back in again. I've had the opportunity to go on the Today Show and Good Morning America and the cover of Women's World. And then if you're familiar with Christian broadcasting, I've been on the 700 Club several times, and with Focus on the Family, I do a lot of work in YFM, and also I do regular, I'm a regular expert with Fox and Friends and Fox News. And so it's one of these things where, have you ever had things happen in your life that you just never could have imagined, like you could never have dreamed it up? And I will tell you, I didn't tell you all that stuff about me because I want to impress you. It's not how I roll. If you knew me for 5 minutes, you'll know I'm not like that at all. Because remember, I was the girl that felt trapped, right? And that's different. It's different than somebody that knew what it was to be fit their whole life. It's a whole different mentality. And so it goes all the way back to when I was, you know, 29 years old. My husband is a big Miami Dolphins fan. Anybody Miami Dolphins fans in the room? A little bit? Oh,
just a lot of it.
And I was in the other room, and I was baking cookies, of course, because that was a ritual for me. I baked a lot of cookies at that time in my life. And I could hear the announcer talking about the game. And all of a sudden, he started talking about one of the players and how this guy was out of control with his weight. They said he came back from training camp and this guy gained a bunch of weight and he looked like a cow on the field. And they said he's up to 350 pounds. And I'm in the other room and I start sobbing because my husband is watching a football game and I'm in the other room and it snapped in a second that I realized that I weigh more than a defensive lineman in the NFL. I mean, it's like when you start to think about it and correlate the two together, you can see how did I get there? And going back to childhood, I was that chubby little girl, but I had a thin sister, and so I was always the one. And you probably heard this phrase before. I was always the one that they would look at my sister and say, oh, she's such a cute figure. And then they would look at my mom and point to me and say, and that one has such a pretty face. Anybody ever heard that? You're such a pretty face. And you want to say, you know that's code, right? That's code for you could be if you would. I mean, that's what you always feel when you've heard it. And so I grew up as that chubby kid. I can remember in second grade sitting down at the hexagon table, and I didn't really know that I was overweight because it just wasn't a topic of conversation as it is today. And as I was sitting there, the girl that's next to me, we're doing a little project together, and she says, so how come your legs are so much bigger than mine? And I thought, I'm going to get back to you on that. And so I went home and I said to my mom that day, Mom, am I fat? And she said, what? Why can't you say that? And I said, well, because I was in school and this girl said to me, and I feel like I'm bigger than everybody else. And she said, no, you're beautiful, and that's just your age, and it'll all even out, and you don't need to ask. Maybe I should go on a diet. I heard the word diet. And she said, no, you don't need to go on a diet. Well, I ignored her, and I decided I would go on a diet. And so for 3 days, I ate basically no food. I mean, I'm like, you know, third grade. I'm not eating at all. My mom doesn't really realize it because I kind of was like, oh, no, I just ate something. And I got to church on Sunday, and the Sunday school teacher was giving out the big 60 cookies. Anybody know what I'm talking about? The big 60s, right? Do they still do that? Big 60s? They do? And so she was doing the little, they were like little butter cookies that were flowers. And she handed them out by the sleeve. You know what I'm saying? She wasn't giving people one or two. It was like, you know, five or six. And she went to hand mine to me. And she said, here's your cookie, Chantel. And I was like, no, I can't have any cookies. And she said, well, why not? And I said, well, I'm on a diet. And she said, little girls don't go on diets. And I said, well, thank you very much. I'll have my cookies. I ended up at that point beginning that journey, that diet diet world, so to speak. And finally, at 29, after trying everything, and I mean, I really believe, I mean, I did. Name some of the diets you guys have tried. Safi, Atkins, give me some more, Weight Watchers. What? Oh, cabbage soup, yeah, I did that one, definitely. I remember, like, on the eighth day of cabbage soup thinking, well, my stomach was hurting, number one. If you've eaten cabbage for 8 days, you know what I'm talking about. And number two, I remember thinking, there's no way I can eat this soup for the next year. You know, like, it dawned on me, this is not reality. I remember there was a diet that I did called the wafer diet, the chocolate wafer diet, and there was these bottles. And I thought this was such a cool diet that I became an independent distributor, right? Because I get the bottles half price. And with this diet, you would have to eat these wafers every day, and you could have nothing but the wafers. And what they really were was they were like Metamucil tablets, okay? And you would have to eat them. I mean, it was like cardboard. I mean, in a, you know, with a chocolate fake flavor. And you had to eat a certain amount based on how much weight you needed to lose. So they gave me 24 of them a day. And the trick was, you eat these wafers one day, and that's all, and water, and then the next day you eat whatever you want. So that sounded like a good plan to me. And the problem was, I ended up kind of reorganizing my life based on that day off. So I'd be like, no, we can't go out to dinner till tomorrow. Then I can have dinner with you. You can't have the party that day because that's a wafer day. People got a little tired of the wafer diet. I thought it was great, but I didn't lose a dadgum pound on it. So as I tried all the diets, everyone that I could possibly think, I tried them all. I ended up one night leaving my church, and it had been a rough week. I mean, I remember I had been on an airplane just prior, and I felt every person looking at me as I walked down that aisle thinking, please don't let her be sitting next to me. I felt it. Nobody said it. I just felt it. I remember going and trying to sit in a movie theater, and the chair just smelled and hugged my behind. I remember going, this was all in the weeks prior to the big night that I'm going to talk about. I remember going to a birthday party with my children, and it was like a swimming party, and I was mortified because I didn't want to be seen in a bathing suit. And I thought, everybody's going to think, look at her, the fat mom, how sad for her children. You know, that's how I felt. And it was real. It was real for me, and it was real when it comes to how other people treated me, because there is absolutely a difference in the way people treat others when there's something visible that is a weakness. And nobody can argue with me about that.